Hello guys, welcome to BuddyDevelopers, and in this video we will learn specifically about a plugin in WordPress called Geodirectory. So Geodirectory is a business directory plugin, so you can create business directory websites like yelp.com using this plugin in WordPress. Geodirectory has several default themes like Woop, Directory Starter, Supreme Directory. You can go to demo.iocode.io and check the different demos available of these themes. So you will see that this website, the Woop theme, is exactly look like the yelp.com website. So here I am in my WordPress, simple WordPress local site, and I have installed this plugin of Geodirectory. I will activate it, and there we have a setup wizard. So I will run this setup wizard because it provides easy way to set up this plugin. So let's proceed. So here in the map section you have three map options, whether you want Geodirectory, OpenStreet or disable the map. Google Map is fully supported, and but since it has some limit for free version, and for paid version you have to activate the premium plan. So I will go for OpenStreet Map here, and then the language will be English. And since OSML does not need any API key, so I will leave it blank, and then I will continue. So here I will have to set the default location for my website. Since I am in India, I will type my current location. Reason is so as soon as I click on the set map, it automatically picked my location. Let's continue. And there is the recommended plugin by Geodirectory. One is iocode connect, ninja form, and user WP is for the one when you need your website to have user profiles for that also, and also for login and registration form creation. User WP plugin is very helpful. Ninja form plugin is for creating contact form for different listing and claim listing form. So this plugin is also helpful and compatible with the Geodirectory. iocode connect help you to connect with Geodirectory support instantly, so this plugin is also required. So I will continue to installing the recommended plugin. So once I installed it, I will come back to this screen. So now that all the recommended plugins are installed, I will click on continue. And here I have option to install dummy content. So I will recommend when you are using Geodirectory for the first time to install this dummy content, because then you will have the exact look like the demo sites. So I will go for it. I will install instead of installing 30, I will install 5 posts first. Let's insert the 5 posts, and then I will insert the footer bar for sure. I need that, and then menu. Once it all get imported, I will come back to this screen. Posts are imported. I will go further, continue it. So here I am, my website is ready. I will go and create the first listing that I want. So since I have already imported my demos, I will just go and check them. So here I am with a basic website with WordPress basic theme. Let's go and install Geodirectory theme. So the primary theme of Geodirectory is Directory Starter, and rest are the child theme of that theme. So either you can install Woop theme, but that will require Directory Starter anyhow, because that's the parent theme of Woop theme. So let's install Directory Starter also, because that is required. So now both of the theme are installed. I will activate it. Okay, so here we go. We have the website set up in Geodirectory default theme. So here you can see the places page is showing this layout. Let me go to the home page. Since home page is not set up yet, so let's go and set up the home page. For that I will go in the home pages section and I will create a home page. I will name it home page, and here I will go for selecting the template of this page. So template is to book home, and we'll publish this page. So this page, you will have the look of home page. So let's set up this page as the home page now. So how we can do that? By going to the setting, the reading, and here we will mention that our home page is our home page. Okay, let's go and now refresh the main website page and you will have the look of the home page here. Okay, so now here you can see that our home page is set up. So let's take a look of different pages of Geodirectory in a short period. So here is the home page, and when you click on places, this is in WordPress terminology we call it archive page. And then I click on individual listing and we call it detailed listing page or single listing page of the business directory. So let's add some sidebar here to get a better info, better look. So we'll go in the appearance section in the visit, and here we have different sidebar. GD sidebar is the one that we need. So we will just drag this GD visit from blog GD blog sidebar to GD sidebar. Need this to recent post? No, we don't need. Let it be there because it's WordPress default search bar. Let's refresh our single page and see. Okay, so there we can see that it's nice looking detail page. Detail page and with all the information of the listing, and then you have the different tabs. So this is the detail page. You also have a add listing page, so where user can add a new listing. So it is the one. And then you have the location page, where since Geodirectory listings are connected with a particular location, a city, country, region. So this location page is kind of an archive of all the locations, and then you can have the individual location page too. So honestly, this location page is really helpful when you have multi-location setup, multi-location entry setup on your website. Then this could be helpful for you. So let's see search page. So search page is the one we call it search result page. So from wherever you search, either from home page, from the top header, you will be redirected to this search page with all the detailed info. So basic search is that you can search by location too. And then you have this user profile thing. So it is from the user WP plugin. So right now here no tab. So we will, you know, in the upcoming video series we will look how you can set up this profile page. And then there are different options that this plugin provide. For non-logged in user, it will also provide you login and registration page if you have enabled the login and registration on your website.
Yeah, so here we can see the pretty good looking registration page. We will see how we can see currently user registration is not allowed, so we will go in the setting. And we will click this allow anyone can register. So when I refresh my page and I go to the sign up again, so there we can see that I can now register. So we will also see in the upcoming video series how we can customize this registration form, how we can add new fields and customize it in better manner. So this is the basic demo of Geodirectory and Geodirectory. How to set up a Geodirectory plugin and how what are the different pages that Geodirectory have. So we have seen it in a quick demo, and in the upcoming video series we will go one by one in different different paradigm that you need to know when you are building your website in Geodirectory. So we will learn everything like from setting to setting of page in a better with a better design. And also we will learn when something some bug arise, how you can fix that bug, and when something uncertain happen, how quickly you can fix those things. So in this video series you will learn everything about Geodirectory from a Geodirectory expert. So if you like this video and you want to stay updated with the Geodirectory plugins related work, and you want to know everything about Geodirectory, just hit the subscribe button and bell icon. So see you in the next video. Bye bye.